Hi everyone and welcome back to another video of Kiwi Investments. A lot happened in the year 2020 and let's now see which publicly traded companies made a profit and which companies suffered a huge loss. Let's get straight into it. If you go down to the video description and click on the first link, it will bring you to this spreadsheet right here. And in this spreadsheet, you will get over 300 publicly traded American companies with the ticker symbol they are trading at, the industry they are in, because it's very unlikely that you will know all of these companies. You also get the current share price of the company. This could be delayed by up to 20 minutes. And you also get the percentage of 52-week low and the percentage of 52-week high. Most financial pages like Google Finance give the price of 52-week low and the price of 52-week high, but I have converted that into a percentage here to better understand where the current share price is. And then we have the net income reported for each quarter for the last 5 quarters. So in the US, if you run a publicly traded company, legally you are required to report earnings on a total of 4 separate occasions throughout the financial year. That is why it's called quarterly earnings report. This spreadsheet has the net income for the last 5 reports. Net income is one of my favorite things to look at when I'm looking into a company. Net income is different to total revenue, gross profit, operating income, EBIT, and EBITDA. I went over the difference and how net income is calculated on a previous video. That video should pop up on your screen at the end of this video, in case if you haven't seen that yet. Also, a common misunderstanding is that companies release their financial statements at the same time, much like how everyone has to file their personal tax. But this is wrong. Companies can choose when their financial year starts and ends. Therefore, they will be releasing their quarterly earnings at different times throughout the year. For example, Adobe has already released their 4th quarter earnings. Meanwhile, companies such as Coca-Cola has not. Tesla is another one that has not released their 4th quarter earnings yet. So this spreadsheet represents a snapshot of the latest income reports available at the time of making this video, which is just a few days after 2020 has ended. And I have set up the colors to represent something as well in this spreadsheet. So in the net income section, if the sales shows up red, that means they have not made a profit. Their net income was negative. So for example, AES Corporation has reported a net loss of $333 million. But if the sales shows up green, that means they have not only made a profit, but they have beaten the last quarter's profit. So for example, Ameren Corporation has not only made a positive net income, but they have also beaten the net income of the last quarter. And this sales shows up green as well because they increased their net income from the previous quarter as well. And the sale will show up light blue if they haven't been able to beat the last quarter's net income, but they have made a positive net income nonetheless. Okay, since there are over 300 companies in the spreadsheet, I will show you how to filter some companies out, arrange them in however you want, and just overall how to play around with the spreadsheet, so that you can then use the spreadsheet however you want. I use it to discover new companies that might be going under my radar, just because they are not glamorized and hyped up, like Tesla for example. So if you come up to the top left tab over here and click on data, and then go down to filter view and click on create temporary filter view. That will then create this new filter view. You will now be able to click on this icon on the top header and arrange the spreadsheet in however you want. So for example, if you go to percentage of 52-week high and arrange them from highest to lowest, you will get companies that are trading at near all-time highs. So for an example, Xylem and Goldman Sachs are both trading at 0.08% below the 52-week high. So depending on you, you may or may not want to buy these companies at the current share price. But if you were to change this from lowest to highest, we have a cannabis company and an oil company that is trading well below the 52-week high. You can play around the same way with the 52-week low, or if you have certain companies in mind that you want to look at, then you can come to names, hit clear all, and then type in the name of the company you want to look at. So for example, let's go Tesla, make sure Tesla is ticked, and let's have a look at another company. Let's go Apple, make sure that is ticked as well, and then go okay. Then you will only get Apple and Tesla to have a look at. So right now, the current share price is 149% off the 52-week low and only 4.4% off the 52-week high. And they have both been doing really good with the net incomes. Let's get rid of the filters. Alright, so you can have a play around with all these headers in a similar way. Feel free to have a play around. One last thing I want to show you in the net income section is how you can play around with the colors. So if you want to know which companies had the biggest net loss in the latest quarter, then you can change this from highest to lowest. So there we go, Delta Airlines has reported a net loss of $5 billion, and they also reported another loss of $5 billion in the previous quarter. If we were to go and apply filters to the colors, then click on the little icon again and then come down to filter by color. Not sort by color, but filter by color. And then you can select which color you only want to see. So if you go light blue, so these are the companies that made a positive net profit but were not able to beat the last quarter's net profit. And when you add filters by color, you can also arrange the spreadsheet in however you want. So for example, the spreadsheet is now only showing companies with blue net income. So we can go to another cell, let's say for example, the 52-week high again, and then change that from lowest to highest. So right now, the spreadsheet is showing companies that have not been able to beat the last quarter's net income, and it is arranged in a way that is showing the companies which are the furthest away from the 52-week high. Or you can go the other way and go highest to lowest, and these are the companies that are near the 52-week high, but were not able to beat the last quarter's net income. Let's change the filter again for another example. Let's filter a different color. Let's go green. And for the previous quarter, let's go green again. And let's do the same for the quarter before that as well. And again for the quarter before that as well. So this is interesting. Only two companies have been able to consistently beat their net income for the last four quarters. Let's try something else. Go filter by red. We have 10 companies that have had very bad four quarters. And as you can see, most of them are in the oil industry. Anyways, now that you know how to play around with my spreadsheet, click on the first link in the description and have a play around yourself. If you do like the spreadsheet, all I ask in return is a like or a subscribe so I can keep making spreadsheets like this for you. If you do have a company in mind and it's not in my spreadsheet, comment down below and I will add it to the spreadsheet. I may do this video again at the end of 2021 or maybe halfway through 2021. Thanks for watching and stay safe.